Hey Dragon Slayers, today's video is about fasting for a younger, smarter you. Don't forget to like and subscribe because it really helps the channel out. Let's get started. The most obvious benefit of fasting is that it helps with weight loss and type 2 diabetes, but there are many other benefits including autophagy, which is a cellular cleansing process, lipolysis, which is fat burning, anti-aging effects, and neurological benefits. In other words, fasting can benefit your brain and help your body stay younger. Mammals generally respond to severe caloric deprivation by reducing organ size, with two prominent exceptions, the brain and, in males, the testicles. Reproductive function is preserved to propagate the species, but cognitive function is just as important and highly preserved at the expense of every other organ. This makes a lot of sense from a developmental standpoint. Suppose food is scarce and difficult to find. If cognitive function started to decline, the mental fog would make it much harder to find food. Our brain power was one of the main advantages we have in the natural world is our brains, and that would be completely squandered. So what actually happens during caloric deprivation is that the brain maintains or even boosts its abilities. The best-selling novel, Unbroken, by Laura Hillenbrand, describes the experiences of American prisoners of war in Japanese internment camps during World War II. During their extreme starvation, the prisoners experienced some astonishing mental clarity that they themselves understood was due to the effect of starvation. One man was able to learn Norwegian in just under a week. Another described reading entire books from memory. Humans, like all mammals, have an increase in mental activity when hungry and a decrease when satiated. We have all experienced a food coma. Think about how you feel after a big meal, Thanksgiving or otherwise, complete with turkey and pumpkin pie. Are you mentally sharp as a tack or dull as a concrete block? Despite popular belief, it's not the tryptophan in turkey that causes the postprandial drowsiness. In fact, turkey has about the same amount of tryptophan as other poultry. It's just the sheer amount of food. As the amount of blood going through the digestive system is increased to handle all that turkey and pie, less blood is available to the brain. About the only mental challenge we can handle after that enormous meal is sitting on the couch and watching football. How about the opposite? Think about a time that you were really, really hungry. Were you tired and sluggish? I doubt it. You were probably hyper alert, your senses sharp as a needle. Animals that are cognitively sharp and physically agile during times of food scarcity have a clear advantage when it comes to survival. If missing a single meal reduced our energy and mental acuity, we would have even more trouble finding food, making it more likely that we would go hungry again, leading to a vicious cycle ending in death. That's not, of course, what happens. Our ancestors grew more alert and active when hungry so that they could find their next meal. And the same thing happens to us today. So that's what I've got for you guys today. Don't forget to like and subscribe because it really helps the channel out. And remember, guys, that together, you and I will slay the dreaded diabetes dragon.